So while you do your roll call, just say hi.
Eddie?
Please. Yeah.
Okay, you're here.
No, it's not. Yes, it's hi.
Yep.
Damn it, you.
Alright.
You failed.
Well, hello, everyone. To session 9002.
Do I have to name it that now? Is that what we're doing? We're going straight to the 9000?
No, I completely forgot what I said.
War of the Apocalypse. 15, I believe.
Alright, we're on number somewhere between 13 and 16.
Good enough.
And, yeah, so last week, the adventurers, I guess, salvaged what they could from Midmeadow, and the, people that were able to get out of the town are heading to Stowick to find out where they could go, or if they can stay there, stuff like that.
There you go. Okay. There's a summary for you. That's a summary of the last episode.
Okay, I gotta see this. Yes. Pretty much. Jimmy's.
Alright, hold on. Wait. This
on maximum rust.
That's the best summary of the last episode.
What? Hold on, I gotta take off the banner so people know what the fuck this is. The shit is this!
So, also last week could be summarized by said picture put on the map.
Yes.
But that is for another time. And another story, because today's story starts off where we left off last week.
A story of great hooves and dust clouds.
You guys ended off at
the middle of the field.
Yes, just because it was getting kind of late, so we wanted to stop there. And RNGesus says, you are fighting.
Our inner demons.
Which very well seems to blend. Which, actually intentional. And we do not have happy cheery music, we have now battle music.
What the hell is that thing next to us?
That's been here for the past like 4 weeks.
Our ghost wolf.
That's my ghost wolf, dude. I've been summoning that for like weeks now.
I don't think I was here that one.
Yes, you were.
No, actually, he wasn't.
He wasn't
here actually, because I didn't get the ghost wolf until we left to go to the keep, and Eddie was out those weeks.
Phyrnna, the ghost wolf has been there for ages. Look at that. There's a spackle man.
No, that's fair.
It's a spackle golem.
I don't know what the ghost wolf was. That's totally acceptable.
Sorry, go ahead. I didn't mean to be an ass.
We got ambushed, right?
When? Now?
Well, basically I'm asking, do they have time to summon Malachi or not?
Yeah. Let me throw him on the,
Okay.
Thank you.
I didn't do.
I normally just have him hidden, and then if you ask, I would think about this. But no, it's kind of here, but as you approach, it gets kind of hostile. But you're far enough away to, like, catch up with everyone after summoning him.
Okay.
Which he should...
Meanwhile...
I don't know if you've already healed him from resting.
He should be good. I gotta heal him up for a slay real quick.
Why didn't... Whatever.
Well, I know what the hell that thing is.
Rock.
Is it an element?
Is it the element of Spackle?
It is a greater earth elemental.
Quick, Bryce,
of Spackle?
Me, Taren.
I do not.
What good I am? No, I'm joking.
Wake me up on those trees.
Do you speak drywall the knees?
Is it just me, or does the stuff you guys, like, roll look different?
What do you mean?
That's just you.
Huh, okay. So it looks more blocky and... Yeah, I don't know.
It's in safe mode.
It fucking could be.
I gotta remember to get you a PNG of Spork. I keep on forgetting.
It's the same.
Same for me. Okay, so then. Alright, mine then. Even the tent, whatever. I don't care.
I actually made an image for Spork a little while ago. I forgot. I keep forgetting to give it to
him. Really?
Oh, I mean, just it look like a stick figure.
No. It's actually a pretty cool pick. I gotta dig it out again.
Okay. Yeah, I'm down.
While you're, just keep doing. I'll look it up on the sidelines, and then I'll send it to you.
Okay. Initiative for Malachi.
Oh right. For some reason, I thought I rolled it.
Make sure you still have hat.
He's got no spells on him, so hey,
Odette, Warner, you are the first to go.
Oh, how about that? Well, first things first, I'm the realist. No, you are tied
for the realist. Don't get carried away.
What time of day is it right now? Holy shit!
It is. Let me double check, but I'm pretty sure it is mid afternoon.
Mid afternoon?
Actually, no, it is early morning.
Sunny or partly cloudy?
With the weatherman flying above, you just hear
sunny. Good to know.
Good to know.
You're welcome. Alright, so that means I've used up only one of my third levels. Damn, fucking tastic. Alright, then I'm casting haste on the party. Bam.
Oh, I just turned that buff off. Goddamn.
Yeah, I did too. I just turned off rage.
I literally just turned that buff off.
Wow, it just tells you what the. I love that it's like fortitude save.
Oh yeah.
I don't care because about four.
Yeah, I don't know why it does that for every spell. I feel like you should turn
probably
that on.
You can. You go into the. It should be under the description or.
It is. It's
options. That's what it is.
Yeah, when you click options, there's a. It used to be where you had to turn it on. Now you have to turn it off.
God damn it!
All right.
Rip. I have to go and fix all this shit. First things first, I'll eat your brains.
What?
Nothing. I got nothing.
What did happen?
Just remember, everybody, that's also a plus one to your dodge. So add that to your defense tab.
Where does it end? I can't tell. Could I?
Let me change the grid. What we can do about this. What do we think? Black color?
Yeah. No, not black. Not on this map.
Okay, fine.
I can see it better than anything else he's got.
That works too.
That works. So is it in the square? Like, it looks like it's leaking in, so I can hit it from here?
Yes. Or actually...
Because its hand is right there, so...
It ends right here. So where his hand ends. So you can hit it from where you were, yeah.
Haste, 60, charge. Alright, so I charge.
And you provoke. do you want acrobatics?
Yeah.
Yep.
I run in, he swings at me, I do a backflip, yada yada, let's get this done with. We got places to go. We got places to go and people to see.
So yeah, you beat it.
You beat it. GG, let's go.
18 does not hit. Metro. I'm gonna start giving random nicknames now.
You call him Metro?
Oh yep. God.
2030.
One nickname a week.
It's 10 extra movement, right?
No, it's double movement.
30.
For you, double.
Yeah, plus 30.
We'll go here and use my standard action to channel.
Okie dokie. Fiona.
I charge, and I'm not gonna bother acrobatics if it somehow can counter.
It can, so... Was a 36 hit?
Mother of God!
Yes. Yes, it definitely does.
Oh my God. Quick! Get room!
God damn it.
Jesus Christ.
Full damage.
That's minimum goddamn damage. Fuck.
Okay, and I'm gonna attack it.
first one hits. Actually, only one hits.
Yeah, it's just the first one.
So you hit it, and it seems completely unfazed by your attack.
Awesome. Is my hammer bent?
Nope. No. Malachi.
Malachi rushes in. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 5, 50, 55, 60. I guess you'll have to make that a charge then. Boom. Sorry, there. That's what I meant to do. Charge attack. He doesn't have any more attacks opportunity left, does he?
Correct.
Alright, well then. Time to utterly fucking fail with this. As usual. Yes! Malachi back in action!
Just how we like it.
Just the way
it's,
I like
it. Seems like it's every Eidolon. It's not even like just Agatech or just Malachi. It's every Eidolon.
I don't know, man. Futsunishi is on top of his shit.
Futsunishi was rocking shit.
I don't know who this Futsunishi is anymore, okay?
It's like they have to warm up.
Who's Futsunishi, sir?
You saw him like a month ago.
Right.
But who's Futsunishi? I only know Futsunushi.
Wait, what about sushi? Anywho, Spork.
Alright. Since apparently haste just makes me attack, I'm just gonna move here. And, now for the cheesy RP side. As a young orc, Spork was occasionally known for going around the older abandoned huts and destroying them, and he looks much like the mud and wall of those huts. So he's already feeling down, so this brings him some childhood joy. So he's excited, and he just kind of tries to slam it with his sword, and just hopefully hear the cracking of what the walls sounded like when they fell down back when he was a kid. I gotta keep on talking because I haven't found the attack thing yet. Hold on. Swing right there. Let's go. Okay, there it is.
God damn it.
There we go.
First one does not hit.
Okay. Or,
let's get an only one. Golem is going after you, Bryce. 40.
Bullshit.
I got this.
I can't help you, bro. Spilled salt can't do shit.
Is this guy literally just take damage? Is that what we're doing here?
Well, the 40 was against my AC. The 20 is the damage.
Oh.
Mother of God.
And is going with Cleave with the second slam onto Phyrnna.
Bork, this is all you, buddy.
At least it's a 29 yep, for you.
That still hits regardless.
18.
Jesus Christ.
Has anyone ever seen the trailer for the pyro?
Hey guys, you look like shit, are you all
right? Oh. Oh, mother of God. Bibbidi bobbidi boo.
Alright, so
I'm gonna go for it. I need to know. He's gotta make a 19.
On will, correct?
Yeah, 19 will save.
Wait. That's 17 though.
Yeah, but Malachi imposes a -2 to all penalties. And I'm also staring at and I'm also giving him my death glare, so it's actually a 21.
Son of a bitch! I couldn't hear you over that 28, Rob. I think Rob left.
Now you need to play.
Call up does the shuffle.
Bryce.
Fuck this game. Fuck this gay earth.
Oh man.
God damn it.
He's not standing here, is he?
Huh?
He's not standing where my line is, right?
Correct.
Was I able to reach him where I at, or should I have been, like,
yes.
Up here?
No, okay. You're
5 foot.
Okay.
5 foot step that way. Attack, like, on it, because it kind of does.
Got this.
One.
Fritz and confirms. Fritz and confirms.
Are elementals subject to critical hits?
That is what I'm going to double check. Elemental.
Eruptions.
No, I needed to check it anyways.
Hey, this is important because Malachi's also technically
not
elemental.
Subject to flanking or critical hits. or precision based attacks.
Malachi
so,
has penalty as that too.
So, let's see.
I just realized we all just like cast haste and just got excited, just start running and beating up on this poor thing in the middle of the fucking desert. Or he's just taking a shit or something. Yeah, or he's just there taking a shit.
You notice that with each one of your swings, that they just don't feel like he's getting phased by it too much.
Did my knowledge check reveal any type of damage reductions?
What was it again?
It was a 14.
14.
No.
Oh, he's just tough. That's all I know. Hit
going
harder!
To use,
so does it look like it's doing nothing, or just not as much as it should?
Close to nothing.
Oh, Jesus.
Blue flame blast with burning infusion. Burn.
Without a doubt hits, but you feel the same way that your blast isn't as satisfying.
Tell if a blast is satisfying or not?
Does anyone have a water-type Pokemon?
What do you have the blue bubble set for?
Or
blast noise.
If you're flying, for how high you are, otherwise it should be nothing.
At 18 for some reason.
It is user inputted at 18.
Okay.
Mm.
So, are you gonna do that for your burn?
Yeah.
Okay. Worked for me.
All right. I ready up my hammer, even though it felt like I did nothing, and I attack again. Oh. Got to use my...
Plink,
whatever.
Plink. Forgot to use what?
I forgot to use combat expertise, but whatever.
Now. Your first one doesn't hit, and your second one hits, but... he... pretty much just brushed it off so like nothing happened.
I think we might be in over our heads. Malachi going to he's gonna keep attacking, that's all he really can do at this point. Take a 5-foot step that way. And let's go Malachi with the full attack actions. Wrong button, sorry.
Okay. Either way I'll take the 23 for the hit. Ooh. Or unless the bonuses are... Yeah, no. I'll take the 23.
And the 22.
And yes, so...
Yeah!
Just because I don't want to keep repeating myself, you already know.
Yeah.
Fork.
Malachi hits him, he's like, do you bleed?
I do have a question. Is he on fire now?
Is he bleeding and on fire?
First, I will check for bleeding. I mean, yeah, for bleeding.
I don't know if they bleed.
He does not seem to bleed. And for fire.
Alright. Well, Spork sees that he missed his last hit, and he's pissed that he missed the fucking wall. So.
He missed the wall.
So he childishly just roars at it. As angrily as he can, and I'm just gonna do one of these. Doesn't matter if it matters or not, I'm doing it. I haven't even seen the number.
I have to remember what it goes against. I know it's level plus
and plus hit die plus wisdom or charisma.
Wisdom, not charisma, thank god.
So 10 plus whatever its hit die is, and then plus 10.
Doesn't seem phased at all.
That's fine. That's still gonna just make Spork just angry. However, not enough to fly into rage, but angry.
That is your standard action.
I can't. So I can't attack.
Correct.
That's how intimidate works. Unless you have feats to improve your intimidate.
Oh, I didn't know that! I was just roaring to roar!
Well, I rolled it. It was my dumbass fault. So, alright.
I mean, because you didn't know and...
It's alright, I'll take the hit this time.
You sure?
I'll take the hit this time. I'll save one of my new points for a later lesson. This one seems fair enough right now, so I'll take the hit.
So, note to self. Spork has one new point. Okay.
Yes! Can I put that new point in a bank and get some interest off it so I can have some more new points?
When I'm supposed to die, I will try to use it.
Yes! Please, that's the perfect time! Come on, I didn't know that thing with a sword would actually hurt me.
You two are bunched up, so he's gonna go for Spork first. Also, what does on fire do actually?
Take damage.
It just takes
round.
Fire damage.
A d6 of damage
out.
Every round.
It's a 1d6, I think.
Yep. It's like bleeding.
As
roll
in
1d6, and that's how much he takes.
Roll a 1d6.
Bleeding is in he takes damage every time.
Okay, that's I was all. Gonna say. So.
Constant damage, so he takes an action right. to stop it.
Yeah, he has to do like a full round action of like stop, drop, and roll.
Yeah, he could care less.
Yeah, he's like, whatever.
So yeah, that hits you, Spork.
Up, up, up.
And then leaves onto you, Bray.
So I'm 17 damage?
Correct.
Yes.
Okay.
Time to rage. Oh no! Rip. Sorry, Bryce.
Oof.
Hurt!
We wandered too
you
close.
So good.
We wandered way too close to the higher level zone.
So hold on. So okay. Spork ahead with the 35. That's the fire damage. The Spork's damage. So it hit and it confirmed.
Good for you. Normal damage.
No, I was about to say that's like fucking good for me.
However,
Christ,
you are deaf for 1 hour.
What?
Again.
I was just about to say, Bryce, you're not allowed to die because I will feel so guilty by keeping my new point if he dies. But I know you'd respond with what, so I'm already 30, meta.
40, 45, 50, 5, 60. God.
You know it to be true in your heart. You're already waiting to say what. Sorry. I'll shut up.
I would laugh if he actually mutes everything.
Oh!
That would be the best.
Thanks, meta strength.
That would be the best. So hypnotic stare on him.
You can hear now! You can hear!
This guy. This asshole. Alright. And where are you at? Level 1 spells. Let's go for... Alright. I'm doing... Lock gaze. Which, why is that not? So the DC for that should be 16. 20. 20 total.
And that is will, correct?
That's a will save, yeah.
That's not a d10. You said a minus 2, right?
The minus 4, because I've got my lock. It's my hypnotic gate, my hypnotic stares on him. And then Malachi's aura also inflicts a minus 2.
Okay.
So it's a total of 16 for his DC.
Yep,
the yes
he hit. Does not hit.
All right, so he is forced to stare at Odette the whole time. Everybody else has a 20% mischance versus everybody else.
Okie dokie.
If he willingly leaves, he gets blinded. Or if he willingly stops looking at me.
Actually, is this a
mind affecting? So if he's immune to mind affecting, then...
Nope, I'm just double checking. Yeah, doesn't say anything about it.
But if he's not, then we're good. Alright, so he's got to stare at Odette the whole time, which means that everybody else has a 20% mischance. Or he has a 20% mischance on everybody else.
Okay.
Only gonna last for one round. Make it count, guys!
Bryce.
God damn it. So Bryce could see him staring at, like, looking past everybody at Odette now.
Yeah, but I can't hear him doing that.
Alright, Daredevil, calm the fuck down.
What?
Continue with my... One...
Okay.
Spell number two. Two... Taking its time to actually look. There we go.
Petro.
Move action. Hurt. So he's going to do a quick around to see if he can see anything odd around him.
Just looks like normal, just dried up land.
Okay.
Anyone know a wind elemental we can use?
You said that I was only deaf for one round, right?
1 hour.
1 hour.
You'll be deaf for the whole day.
Okay, Fiona.
What was that?
I take up my hammer and I get ready to bash it again.
Neither of those hit. Malachi.
Malachi continues to circle up, so now he's flanking with Bryce at this point. From a 5 foot step, and he's going to attempt to rip and tear. God, why do I keep hitting claw slash? Alright, let's roll again. Fuck it. Good enough. Good enough! Fuck. Also, I don't know if it matters, but Malachi's claws are considered magical, so.
Spork, yell at wall. Wall hit Spork! Spork got hit by wall! No! Oh, apparently yes. Never mind.
There you go, Spork.
Man.
Fucking minimum damages.
Minimum damages.
Alright. This elemental burrows underground.
Uh-oh. Time to go.
I also flew into rage. I was
20.
Oh.
And goes to attack you, Odette.
Okay.
Wait, do I get attack of opportunity because of my thingy?
You do not.
Oh, because it popped up. Alright, I'm going to attempt. Odette's going to...
Fuck you, wall!
Odette's going to attempt to parry. Though, to be fair, he went underground completely before he came back up, right?
Yes.
So he's blinded for one round. Because he broke his line of sight with me.
Okay.
So, I'm going to attempt to parry in
actually,
case.
Actually,
Oh yeah, gotta roll the mischance first.
Well,
50%. Hmm?
Either way, it was just going in a straight line, but, let's see.
But he went underground, so he lost sight of me. He has tremor sense, but that doesn't apply. It's physical sight.
Well, either way, he's still going in a straight line, but, anyone around him is flung back 30 feet.
Including me?
Yep.
Okay.
So actually,
oh, from the ruptures from the ground?
Yeah.
5, 10, 15,
also,
20, 25, 30. Got
don't,
it.
Don't forget vengeance, oh great god of this world.
I don't think vengeance stopped you from feet. Flying backwards.
I know, but if this thing becomes on 1 HP and then, like, Bryce dies, no. No.
And, well, since it can't attack you, boop. Oh,
no. Okay. Well, I'm now out of reach of it, so I don't have to worry about that. So I'm going to attempt to recast my spell again. Malachi is outside of reach, isn't he? Yeah, so it's only a minus two, so it's a total of 18 will save this time. Uh, That is my last. That's gonna be my last mesmerist spell for the day. Yeah, he's fine.
All right, and that was so, for the same stair as before, correct?
Same stair, yeah. So, all right, that's all I can do.
Can I?
Bryce.
Oh.
Not, I'm not prone, right? I just got thrown back.
Yeah, you just got launched back 30 feet.
Haste is still going, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we've got head haste for 7 rounds.
And as you already know,
out of that, come to anyway.
Yep. Let's see. No.
Oh no. Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh no! He's blind though, so 50% miss chance.
Which, if it's gonna roll the damage, because I clicked the button a while ago, it didn't. Okay, good. So, demon under it. Let's go first.
I tried to help.
Oop. 18.
Word. How you looking over there, Bryce?
Like shit, are you okay?
What was that?
How are you looking over there, Bryce?
What was that?
He's
still dead.
Well how played, sir. There,
how are you looking? How's Bryce looking, Nelson?
I feel fine. I don't know about Bryce.
No, I said, how's Bryce looking, Nelson?
Same character, sir.
You know what? You're not deaf to damage, you asshole.
Does not hit.
Intro.
Stay in character, sir. What?
God,
an adhesive medical strip, remember? Bandy is copyrighted.
I don't. Going
to, just a regular fire blast, and
okie dokie.
He hasn't been taking his burn damage.
I actually rolled it on the GM layer because I just made a macro for that easier.
Okay.
Last round was 5 burn damage.
Okay, so, gotta do a heal check on Bryce.
He can't
what
hear
do
you.
I know?
Well, he's.
Are you okay? That's a heal check.
It's not a hear check, it's a heal check.
I don't know, I see here. He is pretty banged up.
About
alright, I relay this to Odette. Bryce doesn't look too good.
Well, you don't know I'm looking for. That's fine. Bryce is looking busted.
Well, yep. Also could be easily justified as you're the only one with all the cure.
I'm the only one with the healing ones. Abilities.
So.
Mama, I need a juice box.
Pretty nice right about now.
I move.
A juice box. Just gonna give him a Capri Sun.
Move 10 feet over this way.
Okay.
Pretty much my turn.
Okay. Malachi.
Alright. The dude's shouting, Malachi, keep me covered. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. And he's gonna rush in with another claw slash. Actually. That everything he could do. Let's think he can do mockery, maybe. Yeah.
And was this as a charge or just normal movement?
Just normal movement. All right, he's gonna go for mockery. And boom. Only 6 bonus damage, not 11 bonus damage.
Actually, even with the 6, this creature starts like. Crumbling and just falls to a pile of rocks.
That son of a bitch!
I think it's because it has no feelings that's why I felt like we did nothing to it.
Hey, I tried to intimidate it.
Which,
well, that's it, which didn't work, so
to be fair,
it has no feelings.
You were actually really close to beating it.
Oh, cool.
Map now. However, RNGesus says you do not have an encounter for the rest of the day slash night.
Okay, so everybody gets rested a little bit. And who needs healing? Line up, Mama Odette.
What?
What?
I'm gonna. Bryce's new name is Lil John.
Okay. Yay!
What?
Okay.
Is that what you're gonna rename your sword, Skeet Skeet?
So we only get one day of healing, right?
Correct.
Yeah, I can hear.
I'm walking like a duck up behind.
What?
Plus my right, level,
so anyway,
so
who needs the healing?
I'm only missing 6 after day healing, so I'm good.
Oh, okay. Who wants the bad touch?
I am at 59%.
59%?
Yeah.
All right, so first.
I'm slightly above 50%.
All right, so that's...
Did you shoot me?
No, I have a macro for both magic missile and heal in case I'm using one or the other.
Who needs heal and die?
Odette's finally lost. She just starts blasting everybody.
This wand is too good. You need to take more damage.
That's one dead finally. So Odette taps you on the nose with it, and then like the wand kind of dies on. She shakes it again, like trying to get some more fairy dust out of it, and just tosses it over her shoulder. Alright, on to the next wand. Alright. Yep. This is great. It's going great! Nope, that one's done for now. So, 1, 2, 3 charges out of that one.
Okay, yeah, who's this for?
This is for Bryce.
Glenda?
I'm going through everybody.
Glenda the good bitch. Elaborate. I am curious. Who is Glenda the good bitch?
Odette's Glenda the good bitch.
What is this a reference to?
Glenda the good witch, but...
Wait, it's that thing?
Wizard of Oz.
Huh?
Wizard of Oz.
Wizard of Oz. You never saw Wizard of Oz, Karzie?
No,
Wizard
I did. I just
Wizard
don't...
Of the Oz. You don't remember Glenda the good witch?
I remember there was another witch. She was...
She was dressed all in white and had
blonde. Wasn't she
hair?
Just like Witch of the East or some shit?
She was Glenda the Good Witch.
I didn't know that.
Is that all you need, Bryce?
I was good prior to that last one. Is that last one for me or is that somebody else?
Oh, no, then that, if you were good, I mean, then I imagine you would have waved her off like, I'm good. And then that
yeah,
one's
I'm
for.
I'm not at full, so I don't need that one.
Okay,
I'm
so then that one's for Phyrnna.
So the 11's for me, okay.
And there you go. How's that? How you doing now?
A lot better than before.
Do you need any more?
I could do one more.
Okay.
That's my daily healing thingy.
Yep. Thank you.
Alright. And Spork, you said you're set, right?
At that. Bunny hunt at the... Aw, that's a sad bunny hunt.
Not today.
Which, actually, speaking of a bunny hunt...
Giggity.
No. Odette, because I forgot to last time, and I forgot to mention it before we started... your last knowledge checks will be updated in your side quest, which the last one from, like, what, 2 weeks ago is there now, finally?
Awesome.
Does it include Bunny Rabbit information?
Don't mind me, I'm not slow.
Solid.
And I'll probably just keep these here, because those are the normal 3 that you roll.
Okay.
So I'll just keep them there until you go to refresh.
Okay, basically, I'm not gonna. My rolls aren't gonna get better until either new information is presented to me about these beyond like my own studies, or until I level up. This is the only way I can redo knowledge checks because that represents everything I currently know. So that's what I'm gonna be with right now. That's good though.
Information is information.
Bunny information is always good information.
So yeah, is there anything you guys want to do tonight?
Nope.
Think about the bunny rabbit and weep for the fallen. That's literally all Spork wants to do. Just look, just feel bad for a bunny rabbit, weep for fallen.
Odette will give Bryce a present. She hands over, she unclasps her necklace and hands it over to Bryce. This ought to help you going forward. I think it'll be most useful in your hands. And I would just like you to have it.
What does this do?
This is my Swarm Bane necklace, but this is the description of it.
That's what a out of character next lot?
Yes, that is the next lot. So it... And I'll give you the full description of the item. As soon as I find that motherfucker. There it is. And this is what the item does.
I thank you and put it on.
Odette smiles, glad to see you immediately taking it. And that's it for now.
Oh, yeah, just remember to take that off your sheet.
Yep, I just did it.
Okay.
Just did it. Alright. In the meantime, that's all. Yeah. Oh, by the way, Spork.
Yes.
I have, I wouldn't say it's a present for you, but it's something that you can definitely enjoy. I have a wand of enlarged person. So, going forward in combat, I can stop at you. Going forward, I can improve your combat abilities and give you large size now.
Spork gives you like a big cheesy grin and says, you use that whenever you want.
That sounds so... questionable when you say it like that.
That makes it even better now.
Well, Odette was always looking for some action.
Look, oh, I don't have Careless Whisper ready, sorry.
look guys. Get off my back about that.
Spork like being a big spork. Spork feel big. When big spork big, you feel big.
Oh god.
Feel like an orc. It's big orc.
Alright, these are potions I'm gonna have to sell off at some point. Of each. That's gonna come down to you. Okay, cool.
Anything else for tonight?
Nah, I think that's good for now. Odette's going to update her personal journal and check through her scrolls and get them prepared for later.
Can I edit my own journal? Is that a thing?
I keep
an out of character journal on the side to just jot down our adventures.
I was just gonna do stupid shit. It's nowhere near important. I was just gonna say sport doodles. On the bottom of this.
Actually, that's all. Cannot.
That's fine.
Yeah, it's not set up for that.
It's probably better that way.
Though you can probably put it in your on your bio on your in your character sheet.
Spork doodles on his journal.
That's... I can see him making a text bunny.
I'd do it.
Do you guys want to stay in this I guess like desert like area, or do you want to head towards the forest? Like, because either way, you're still going to get there. It's just highly.
What's the weather? What's the weather like?
Hot and dry.
Is it going to get cold? Somebody with a survival check. what's it going to be like out here in a while? Because Odette has none of that. She's read the deserts get really cold at night. So.
Either way, you're in the desert for the night. So.
Yeah, well.
Mitra's not worried about the cold.
It doesn't seem to have, like, any signs of getting cold.
Okay. Basically, this is a survival check to see, are we in any danger out here as opposed to being in a forest? But if not, then we'd stay here.
I was just asking as...
We can at least see things coming.
Yeah.
I say just keep going straight then, if there's an, it doesn't pose an immediate danger to us.
Well, as you've already said in, and you know, out of character, deserts do get cold at night.
Yes.
So can it get cold tomorrow? Possibly. Tonight, however, is not.
Let me check. Let me consult our handy dandy map and see where we are. Close to on our journal or on our travels. Oh boy. That's not gonna matter because we're gonna be going. I see. Yeah, you know what? Consider the fact that we ran into a super deadly golem, let's get the fuck out of the desert. That's not a safe thing to do. Let's try to travel through the forest to the hills.
How about super deadly? I mean, it didn't hurt me any.
It didn't hurt me any either, but it almost smashed our melee into paste.
Well, he's not wrong.
I didn't hear a thing.
Alright. God damn it. So.
Bringing presents and joy to work children.
So, you are heading towards the forest, correct?
Yes, that is correct.
Okay. You do not have any encounters tonight, or today. So, anything you guys would like to do?
I guess Odette will ask Micha where he's from. We haven't really had a chance to get to know you, Micha. Well, at least I haven't, anyway. I'd like to know who I'm traveling with.
Did I even set that up?
After he's been with us for like a month.
Hey! God damn it!
Who are you?
I mentioned it once before, and I don't remember if I actually put it in there. No, I didn't re-put it.
Think of it as a fresh start. Pick a place.
Go ahead. Say he was part of Augberg.
Augberg? What's an Augberg? Sorry, Steve.
I was locked in a tower for most of my life there, so aside from the flames that erupted from it when I was finished, I...
Locked in a tower? What were you...
Augberg, but yes.
What were you locked in a tower for, exactly?
Had an affinity for fire.
Well, all children have an affinity for fire. Did you
not
do something
like
with
mine.
That fire? I'm assuming like
seen
lately?
They saw that the fire didn't... It didn't burn my skin like it should have. And when they were watching me from the distance, they saw that I was playing with it, and... All day long, I would sit around either a campfire or playing with the candles in villages and towns.
Sounds like they locked you up because they were afraid of you?
Yeah. I wasn't the only one, and the rest of the towers that I find that are doing the same thing will burn as well.
But it nods. I kind of understand where you're coming from with that. When I was growing up, my family was ostracized. Me and all of my sisters treated like outsiders, so we were forced to travel a lot. Spent most of our lives on the road, until finally I'd had enough and I briefly married into some money, and after my husband passed, I squandered it all away trying to keep my family afloat. But money doesn't last forever, and after a century or two, I had to move on again, and that's how I found myself here.
Did your husband die of his own means, or of yours?
She grins at you. He was old when I married him. Young men don't have money. Only the old do.
You sure about that?
Are you saying you don't believe me?
I'm just saying that I don't believe that young men don't have money.
I look at Odette, like, looks around. Have you seen any recently?
Yeah. You're looking for money. Yeah. I know this paladin who's been handing out buttons to my kids.
I'm sorry, I don't know what paladin you're talking about.
I really wanted to say that too.
I know, that's
correct. I really wanted to say that too.
I understand what you mean, Phyrnna, but I'm talking about inheritances. Large sums of old gold, basically.
Now, that didn't answer my question, though. You said he was old. You didn't say how he died.
He died from age. Maybe disease took him. He was of an advanced age and not in exactly the best health. I did try to take care of him as best I could, but I simply outlived him. I outlived all of them. He kind of like shrugs at that, like half-assed, like whatever.
I think Mitra wanted to ask, did you have fun with him too much?
What?
What?
Mitra doesn't even think about things like that. I'm fairly confident he's leaning more towards, did you kill him?
Kill him,
did you
yeah.
sleep with him to death?
Did I fuck him to death?
The tabloids need to know the details.
Odette kind of like looks Fyodor up and down. It's like, who are you?
Apparently, wait, are you just eyeballing, sizing her up?
Are you real?
Are you real? It's like, weren't you a paladin, like, less than a month ago?
Yeah, that kind of broke me a bit.
Clearly. No, I didn't overexert my husband.
Spork giggles.
Sadly,
just
he didn't
a little.
Really have much energy for that sort of thing. I mostly tended to his needs. I fed him, I bathed him, I walked him around the house, and I tried to keep his spirits up.
What did you say, Mitra?
What?
You walked him around the house?
Yeah, I walked him.
He asked this question.
Sorry.
Oh, my God, I'm sick.
I thought you were saying, I thought you were saying something else before everyone erupted in laughter.
Sorry.
No.
Yes.
If anything, again. I was about to ask what a ballad song was, but then I looked it up and it's like, butterfly now. Gotcha.
Yes. He was, again, very old. He needed assistance to move around.
And he had
humans
money,
become
so I'm sure that was...
Yes, and he had a great deal of money.
You could clearly tell that Mitra was,
judging me?
No, actually. He had He was kind of chuckling.
Yeah.
He was just following along the path of their conversation to make the night
to make
pass
the
through easier.
To make that go, and he had money. Well,
just,
I won't say I didn't. I can safely tell you I didn't marry him for love, but I did
hey,
have a
fondness.
Everybody's
got to do
for
what
him.
They got to do to take care of their family.
Yes, indeed. And I've done everything I can.
On that note, I gotta be right back for real life shit, so.
Gotta be right back for real life shit.
He's like, I didn't know I could sleep with my loved ones for money. Hold on.
Oh, God.
Odette, like, counts off on her fingers. I've had. Three? Three husbands now. Yeah. Three.
He watches Odette count off on her fingers, and he looks down at his hands and pulls him down. Pulls his fingers together. I've had zero wives.
That's good for you. Wives will shorten your life. She grins at him.
But at the tower. Like I'm honestly, I'm surprised to have been allowed to live this long.
You're
I figured
well
they would have tried to have killed me a lot sooner.
You're pretty well socialized for a tower damsel.
You guys saved me from an angel who kidnapped me from somewhere I didn't want to be in the first place. So I'm more apt to be social with all of you than with most of anybody else.
Well, it's good to have you aboard, Mitra. So, Bryce, you mentioned that you knew the individual that gave you that jacket, that you grew up with them. Is that right?
I'm just kind of laying down by the fire. Wouldn't say I know him. He knows of me because apparently my cousin still doesn't show up, but yes.
Your cousin? Who's that?
Cassandra. She's a member of the Knights of the Blood. They wanted to recruit me. I turned them down. But yeah, she apparently talks about me a lot, so a lot of the people from that group know who, or know of me, I should say.
You turned down being a knight? That's uncommon.
Yeah.
Too many rules?
I wouldn't say that. I like everything they believe in. It's, I guess, one of those things where I didn't feel I was ready.
I see.
Too strict.
What was that? I didn't hear what you said, Eddie.
Too strict.
No?
Too strict.
I shake my head. I wouldn't even say strict. Honestly, the way I behave is more or less the way they would expect me to. It's just...
What would
you
think?
It's a high-ranking position. It's not something I feel like I'm ready for.
What do you think would make you ready for it?
For starters, not getting pummeled into the ground by earth elementals.
I don't think many people could get away from that, but I see your point. You did mention before that you're looking for the strongest possible opponent, so I imagine once you've run out of challenges, then you'll think you're ready?
Yeah, and just kind of like look down at the jacket and say, I already got the uniform.
If that's the case, why don't you just start your own group? Your own knights, your own order or school, or whatever you think is necessary.
Not much of a leader.
Udek kind of mulls that over. Fair enough.
That's why you team up with Odette. I think she'll do well for you.
Odette looks at Bryce and waggles her eyebrows at him.
I just kind of chuckle. Maybe when I'm old and full of money.
Even better. Even better. Oh, that's good.
But hey, you're young enough for her to have some fun with also. Now we're just going off topic.
Yeah.
Sorry.
You are really frustrated.
Yes, I am.
You stop being a paladin. You start, you shorten the skirt a little bit, open up the bust line. What happened here? You're cracking dirty jokes? Wow, you paladin girls really cut loose when you get a chance.
I think it's because she hasn't gotten a chance to cut loose yet.
When we get to Wampum, we're having a girls' night out.
Oh yeah!
We'd love to. Never experienced anything like that.
No, I can tell. I can tell. Besides, it's been a hard ride already, and it's probably going to be still hard yet. So we'll need to take we'll need to take time to rest before we really set off. We'll have to learn the ship schedule, see if one's even in port when we get there. If there is, we'll be very lucky. But I suspect that we might be waiting for a boat for a day or two.
About that point in time, they would notice that Mitro's kind of
dozed off.
Not really dozed off. Like they started talking about the girls' night out and frustration and whatnot. And he's just he wasn't part of that, so he got up and walked off and laid down.
Fair enough. Fair enough.
Okay.
Oh God.
Back. Oh.
I was staring at the screen so long, my screensaver kicked in. Jesus.
Welcome back, Karzie.
I haven't touched anything in that long. Welcome back.
Thank you.
So
don't do
now,
it again.
So for now, that's all I got to offer.
Well, it kind of set up. She's not doing well right now.
Set up the watches and let's go.
Yep.
Sorry to hear that, dude.
Okay. So you guys all go to bed. However, Spork, when you wake up in the morning, You notice a note pinned on your tent. In which I will give you that right now. You should have another note. That's just a mysterious note.
Is this in my quest? Oh.
It would be in the same section.
Okay.
It might be actually right below it. I'm not sure.
Spork smiles like a kid on Christmas morning.
He just got told the rabbit ate all of his family.
Spork immediately goes to Odette. Don't care if Odette's sleeping or not or awake. Don't care. Going to her. And immediately...
Shakes me awake.
I do. And I show you this note.
And, Odette immediately grabs like her rapier and like she rolls over and is like death glaring at Spork, but not like looking through him, like she's not completely awake. And then she just like kind of grouses. What?
You also now have the note in your.
I have a question for that in general. Is Spork's intelligence score high enough to read that?
Oh god. Yeah. Either way, okay. He's bringing it to
as long as it's a language he speaks, he can read it typically.
It's in common.
Yeah. Well, I didn't know if that was one of the things where you had to be.
Well, okay, what is Spork's intelligence? That does bring up a good question.
All right, I'll look at it. Core 7.
Ooh, Spork actually. No, I take it back. Spork might actually be illiterate. Barbarians start off illiterate, unless I'm thinking of 3.5 only, but barbarians typically start off illiterate and they don't gain the ability to read any languages until they either gain a positive or a zero intelligence score or pick up linguistics. I could be wrong, so you might need to
review. I don't think Pathfinder does that.
It doesn't say anything about the barbarian page. That's the type of reading
that I'm used to.
Okay, so then he can read, if that's the case, then he can read and write the one language he knows. Okay. The language he knows, which I think are Orcish and right. Common.
Spork way, has I had mean... extensive hooked on phonics as a young orc.
Either way, if it was a rule, I'm not going to do that, so either way, it's null and void.
Okay. So, well, cool.
Spork immediately asks, "What do you think it means by presence?" I know cabbage.
Odette kind of like rubs at her eyes and like takes the note and reads it over like once, twice. I think your rabbit is looking for you. So,
Spork.
If I had to guess, it's a magical rabbit, hence why it can leave you notes. And chances are it wants something special and unique, something just for it. I don't think cabbage will do it this time, Spork. I think you need to get something shiny.
Spork.
We'll see what we can find in town or along the way, but we'll keep our eyes open and see if there's any... I'm trying to think of the word. Tribute that we can offer your mystery rabbit. I'll ask around when we get in town and see if there's any information that I can use for this for you.
Spork
was here to ask you about if you had any ideas about what he means by presence. We went over Spork
again.
And read the note.
No, I'm just saying you spent like the entire time like explaining the note. And it's like
we learned Spork can read. We got that part.
She's not.
I'm asking about the presence part.
She's not awake though. That's the thing.
She's
still waking up. Right. Presence. I don't know. We'll need to find out what kind of creature we're dealing with, and then what it favors. It could be jewels. It could be weapons. It could be art. It could be magic. We'll see.
Okay.
We'll look into it together, Spork.
Spork immediately runs, thanks for Odette, and runs to Phyrnna's tent.
Oh no!
Wakes up Phyrnna.
So nobody in the group is gonna have sleep tonight.
Well, this is when you guys already wake up.
Okay, so I'm just still waking up. That's all.
He shoves the note in her face and asks, "What? Give me ideas for presents."
platinum life hotkeys.
Platinum hatbox.
Waiting for the note to appear.
Should I just copy and paste in chat? I can do that for just easy sakes there.
Because I see a pattern forming.
Yeah, no, yeah, you're right. This is a pattern that's continuing.
And last time you lifted a cabbage?
No, Spork never got the cabbage. He got carrots, and then he was told that the rabbits like cabbage, not carrots. So...
I thought rabbits like both.
I guess he likes cabbage more. Spork was told he likes cabbage more. So, Spork was trying to find cabbage in that last town, but the last town was destroyed, and Spork wasn't allowed to rob a food vendor.
I think your best bet at this moment is to go with what knowledge you already have. We should look for that cabbage still. And if it
magic
doesn't
cabbage.
Work...
That's what we need.
If it doesn't work, we'll have to ask around and find out what else.
Dennis, should I just roll up my should I just roll up that gourmet anyway?
God damn it.
Spork.
Oh my god, so perfect.
Spork thanks Fiona, and then goes out of her tent, looks around, sees Mitra's tent, just goes no.
Oh god, here we go.
And he sees Bryce's tent. And he runs in, and he wakes up Bryce, shoving this note in his face. He says, "Fledgling, Spork need president ideas." Spork needs ideas for presidents.
He wakes me up, I just kind of go up yelling. I refuse to say it. What?
Spork, Spork need ideas for presents.
If you're impressing with that money.
There you go.
No. For magical rabbit.
It's gonna look... I'm like rubbing my eyes. Magical rabbit? Magical carrot?
What kind of fledgling are you?
A tired one?
Confused one?
Spork size. He's like... In the very, very, you know, you, how to say it? Has anyone seen the World of Warcraft South Park episode?
Yes.
All right. In the Cartman talking to Butters voice.
Oh no.
Spork goes, "The magical rabbit we've all been hunting for the past weeks." I wish I had more words to say here. That was a terrible
build-up. I feel like Spork trails off halfway through the magical rabbit that we've been searching. It's like, oh, use the ball's intelligence, back to normal. halfway through the words.
Oh, man.
God damn it. My real life intelligence is only 6. This isn't fair.
To be fair, Karzie, play what you know.
Can I make Spork dumber to make him stronger? Get him on my level. But the magical sensation that we've all been chasing, the magical rabbit that has a purple cloak and has a chain around its cloak, the magical rabbit that Spork's been hunting for the past few weeks.
Why does this sound like a character out of Alice in Wonderland? I'm sorry.
Spork just gives a very, very unsatisfied anime dumb face and just walks out of Bryce's tent then.
I walk over as I see him walk out sad. What's wrong?
Bryce says, "Buck!"
Odette starts breaking down the, starts breaking down the camp.
I think we should move on and you're just overthinking this.
No.
We'll get something once we hit town. Don't worry.
And by Odette breaking down the camp, that means to say that she has Malachi break down the camp. With dead hangs back and drinks
her. I'm just cleaning it off. Because anytime we go back to the, what's it called, map? Encounter map. There, you guys are still there, so. And all the other crap I rolled. So, anything, else you guys gonna do for the morning, or just break down and head out?
That's all for the morning. Top of the morning to ya. Who did? Where you at? There we go.
So still early in the morning.
Taking off my spells.
You guys, actually are up closer to here. And Odette, you can already get a strong sense of magic while you're going, like, getting closer to this area. So give me either a spellcraft so you can try to identify it.
Spellcraft it is, sir. Give me a sec. Man, the new spells page just totally fucked me up. There's so many more boxes now. Spellcraft.
The price changed?
Oh, shit!
Yeah, so you can tell that, the area you are going through, very, very recently, there has been invisibility spells casted.
Oh, shit. Guess what time it is?
Glitter dust.
Goddamn straight it is. Oh, that's fucking brilliant.
However, these creatures do know to wait till you pass, but they're not that smart, so the second they think they have any advantage, they all pop out.
Oh shit! Change this picture.
What the hell is that?
He recolored it for the coat.
No, not that.
Oh.
You're right, they're not that smart. They're not even facing the right way.
Yeah.
They snuck up on us, guys. We have the element of surprise.
All right, here we go. That's a little scary. So, knowledge arcana. What are those things?
They are owl bears.
That's why they look like owl bears.
That's what I kind of figured, but I wanted to make sure. I don't want to just assume that player knowledge is my character knowledge.
Are these things?
And they came out of they popped actually out of invisibility.
Correct. Oh no, we crazy just listened to that.
Alright, I'll do it like this. Skills.
And I don't even need to say this, but as you know, they cannot cast spells. So.
Yes, well.
For any reason, the spork think these things are friendly.
Owlbears are owlbears are magical beasts, which means they have starting attitudes of neutral, but tend to be hostile because, like bears, they're very fucking territorial.
Yeah.
They are hunters like owls. So, but you can try to handle animal, but you're only going to be able to do it to one at a time, and there's a lot of them. We have a better chance of just fighting our way out of this.
But Spork really likes them. They're owl bears. Come on.
They're horrifying. Imagine Leonardo DiCaprio.
Why don't you try walking up to one and liking it?
I will.
You can instantly tell as soon as
they're hostile, like, as fuck.
As they pop out, they just start roaring and growling. So you can tell easily they're hostile.
They're hostile.
Okay.
Which, by the way, since the top right one is in your wolf's aura, what does it have to do?
It depends on the creature's CR. If it's a CR lower than 6, it has to make a will save versus...
Oh god.
I don't know if these are different than that.
Yeah, no, they're low, so...
Okay, well then, any creature that gets caught in my wolf's aura has to make a will save versus DC. Where are you at? Right page, there we go. That is a 4th level, 3rd level spell, so DC 18. You know what? I'm getting burnt out on this bullshit.
Alright, so
it's not a...
He wasn't even in range of my glare anyway, so whatever.
This is out of character. That wolf doesn't join the fights, right?
It just not unless I tell it to. It's present, but if it joins the fight, then it changes the duration of the spell.
Okay.
So I usually keep it out of combat until something gets too close. Then, of course, it's gonna fucking fight.
Okay.
Top left one is a little too close for his comfort. God, there are a lot of them. I didn't even scroll down.
Yeah, there's a shitload of them, dude.
Peter is going to use his shirt and double charge. Use burning infusion, flame blast.
Like you get cooked owlbear, boys.
Owlbear now, boy.
And it is burning, correct?
Yeah.
Alright. Just making sure. Which one is this one? Okay.
It's... never mind.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Enters the aura. Oh god.
Oh, he's super scared.
So what is he just shaken or?
It's shaken, I believe. Let me verify, but I'm pretty sure the spell operates as just shaken. It's as the fear spell, basically. Let's make sure. Ghost Wolf, where you at? Yep, shaken for 1d4 rounds.
Go ahead and roll me a 1d4 then.
Four rounds.
Alright, so what is his initiative? 2105 minus 2 on. However, because he did fail that, critical fumble.
Easiest way to deal with that is to just escalate it to the next level. 10 typically, but you can do whatever you want.
So you tore a hole in the dimension.
No, like if it makes sense, like I'm gonna do the roll. If it makes sense, what the roll says. Otherwise, I will just move up a step. Yeah. So, pretty much, he just is so scared that he's just
Lanix.
He's pretty much to the point of like he doesn't even want to go in anymore. Like he's just like I don't want to do this anymore.
He's rooted.
Spork goes in for a charging hug.
I never asked for this.
Wait.
Oh god.
Never mind.
Not you. Not that one.
Oh, I thought that was the one that was afraid.
It is.
Yeah, charging hug. It's scared.
Yeah, that one's afraid. That one has resisted. But we're getting surrounded on the opposite side.
There's a lot of them.
Into the fear aura.
Beats it.
Yeah.
Welcome to the jungle.
Oh god, they know the Mighty Ducks win.
We're fucked. We're so fucked. Okay.
These aren't just owlbears, they're Canadian owls.